Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2, Blind, on the RPG check. Before I head back to the school to look for a statue torso for our golem, see if these guys have anything new to say. Blout's always fun to talk to him.
Hello, Blout.
Wilbur.
Hmm.
Hi,
nope.
Blout.
Nothing new.
Bye.
He won't say it.
Hello, Sloth.
Ah, Wilbur. Greetings.
Hmm. About Bill and Mr. Shieldhand.
About the whole bringing down Bill thing?
Yes.
I'm afraid it didn't quite work. Sorry.
I wasn't exactly full of hope. And even if Bill did get his knuckles wrapped, someone else would have come and taken his place. It's the system that doesn't work.
Broken!
The merchants are all in cahoots and fix the prices among themselves.
See you, Sloth.
So long.
He didn't have anything to say to that. Let's see what the delightful headmaster has to say.
He's unfair to me.
Yep. Never mind him. Alright, we gotta get back to the school then. Come on. I've been clicking, trying to get him to move.
It looks like Bill's delivery's finally arrived.
Oh. I was headed to the school. His delivery? Oh, you mean he can get us overnight delivery of crocodile tears? Looks like we've got a whole crocodile, though.
This box is supposed to move. I've heard of trunks with hundreds of legs, but this looks like a normal packing crate. Hello, Bill.
Wilbur.
Do you have the crocodile tears?
Do you sell crocodile tears?
Can order them.
No. Okay.
I have to be going, Bill.
See ya.
So then... Forgive me, I must have forgotten. There's some other delivery?
Oi, what are you doing?
This crate is moving.
That's all right. That's... Stop him! Stop!
What is that?
Stay put! Outrageous! Just you wait. You're gonna have to wait a hell of a long time for your goal.
What was that? Absolute bonkers.
Go on. Search the crate.
Ooh, there's a piece of paper in the crate. Delivery note. Better World Ironworks. One pisspot model carefree. 4 pieces of gold. Better World Ironworks. Never heard of it. Lots of new companies sprung up after the war. A delivery note from the Better World Ironworks company. They must have made the pisspot.
The pisspot. Just talk to him first.
Hello, Bill.
Wilbur.
What the hell was that running away from us?
That thing running about over there? What is it?
A darn scam, that's what it is. They won't get a penny out of me, sending me such a wild thing.
Yes, but what exactly is it?
A pisspot! Sounded like a good idea. We equip pisspots with legs. You don't do the walking when it's time to empty your bladder. But why the devil give a pot legs that means he scurries about like a boar on fire?
What are Better World Ironworks?
What are these Better World Ironworks?
They're those darn crooks what sold me this useless pisspot. Those do-gooders.
Do-gooders?
Yes. They collected swords, armor, and all that stuff after the war. Plow blades from swords, piss pots from helmets, that kind of rubbish.
You mean this piss pot was once some soldier's helmet?
Could have belonged to a general for all I care. Now it's a piss pot on the run.
Ah, a soldier's helmet converted into a piss pot with legs. No wonder he doesn't like it.
Reminds me of Nate's helmet from the first game.
I have to be going, Bill. See you next time.
See ya.
Alright, now I'll show him the thing. Oh no, I can't. Show him the protest posters.
Can I interest you in a few of the protesters' posters?
No, I've still got those requests from the war orphans, and I'm not that cold.
What? But a drink on me, you know? Oh, I forgot I had this. See that? Let's see, enter what? Yeah. Look at the window. Why am I looking at the window?
Hard to tell exactly what time it is, but the night is still young. If golems really are as industrious as the slate claims, it will have plenty of time to complete the headmaster's tasks. And as of dawn, he could then serve as Archmage Alistair's bodyguard, at least until the election. Hopefully the situation will calm down afterwards. Remy hinted that I should have a look around in there. Something about the headmaster isn't quite right, that's for sure. The door's bound to be locked. Wonder if I can crack it.
It's alive.
The door handles look like stupid ears. A coincidence or a silly designer.
Stupid ears, huh?
I heard that.
You can talk.
And hear. And who are you calling stupid?
You, sir. Why does everything in this world have to be able to speak?
You can hear and speak.
That's not what I want to say.
Certainly.
Why? I mean, why must everything be alive?
How could I hear the access code if I didn't have any ears?
Access
and
code.
How could I tell you the code is wrong if I didn't have a mouth?
You have a point.
Well, I'd like to go into the staff room. I'll waive the access code.
I teach at this school and I'd like to get into the staff room.
What is the code?
I'm starting to get the feeling that someone's deliberately put in obstacles in my way.
It's called life.
No, I mean that quite literally. It's like there's someone out there, somewhere, who has nothing better to do than think up one problem after another for me to solve. There's no other explanation.
It's called a game designer. I don't know the code.
I don't think I know the code.
No entry without the code.
Hey!
Presumably the headmaster just forgot to tell me.
No entry without the code.
Hey.
I have to get that code somehow.
Yeah, we sure don't have that many things to do now, do we?
I have to go. I have something to do down in the town.
I don't care. I'm just a door.
Yeah. Too bad we can't use that statue torso. I mean the knight in shining armor torso. Can we use that for a torso?
Should be easy to find enough soot for the ink here. Yep, lots of soot. Now I just
ink.
Have to figure out the right amount. A small heap of soot from the stove. I think the soot is supposed to give the ink its black color. The only problem is, I need exactly one sea stone small ounce of it. If I have to mix some magic ink, this is certainly the best place to do it.
Oh, we're gonna mix stuff.
crocodile tears. Unfortunately, all of the liquid is evaporated. All that remains is a white powder, like salt.
And water.
All that's left of the crocodile tears is a bit of salt. The recipe calls for a 2 cl of crocodile tears. That means it has to be a liquid. All that's left... Ah, excellent. I can mix the ink in this pot. Once I have all the ingredients for the magic ink, I can mix it up in this little pot. Once I have...
Okay. Can I just put this in here now, then?
According to the recipe, I have to add exactly 1 seastone small ounce of soot to the ink. And I'm not sure that this is 1 seastone small ounce.
Well, that would be for this thing.
A scale for weighing ingredients. This could be useful. Unfortunately, most of the counterweights are missing. It seems only the 3 seastone small ounce weight is there.
I need 1 seastone?
Once I have all the ingredients for the mag...
Hold on a second.
According to the recipe, I have...
Alright, so... We need 1. This only has 3.
A scale for weighing ingredients. This could be useful. Unfortunately, most of the counterweights are missing. Counterweight. 3 seastone small ounces. On one side of the scale, there's a 3 seastone small ounce weight. On the other side, nothing. On one side of the scale... The counterweight weighs 3 seastone small ounces, but I have to weigh out exactly 1 seastone small ounce of soot.
Yeah, so what the hell are we gonna do? Did I put something else on here? Hold on. Well, what else we got to look at? Well, that's it.
Once I have all the ingredients... On one side of the...
Alright. Well, we can't even look at our bedroom anymore. Come on, Wilbur. You have any 1 seastone counterweights?
What is the access code? I don't care.
Alright, I do have to go out.
Hello, Bill.
Wilbur.
I have to be going, Bill.
See ya.
Alright. I could use the map to go around, but I do need to look for this pot. Wait a second. It won't let me go there anymore.
Empty boxes and packaging material. I can't see anything that in... Hey, what do we have here?
That's the pot.
Pretty good runner.
I had to specifically go there to find it. All right, let's go down now. Hey. Hermit with legs. Piss pot.
Don't jump. You were once a soldier's helmet, right? And the way you look... Not just any soldier, either. And now they've turned you into a magic pisspot.
Hmm.
That That's a shitty job.
Almost literally.
I so understand why you ran away. You fought for good, went through so much, and now... How would you like to do great things once again? For your commander-in-chief? I'm building a golem to protect the Archmage. You know Archmage Alistair, don't you? He's in danger. Maybe the shades are behind it. But definitely a dark power. You could be the golem's legs. It would be an honorable task.
It's going to be one hell of a golem.
So you're in? Deal, little helmet. Don't cock it up.
These jokes are getting a little raunchy.
The magic pisspot's legs may not be very thick, but they seem strong. I'm sure they could carry a golem body. In principle, they belong together. It's just that the torso in between is missing.
Yeah, I need a torso. Timmy? Who's this?
Hi, Timmy. What are you doing here?
I want to know what's going on. All the rats have orders from my uncle except for me.
Huh.
I want to help too.
I'm not sure.
I understand that you want to help and have a real soft spot for little heroes. But you're not the strongest and your health isn't best.
The Archmage staying in power is much more important for the small and the weak than anyone else. We would be the first to suffer under the council leader if she won.
You could be right there. I'm trying to build a golem, and I have to get into the staff room somehow.
Yeah.
I could find a way into the staff room. There are lots of secret tunnels and passages under the tan. One of them is sure to lead there.
Sweet.
Hmm.
Tell me about the tunnels.
Tell me about the tunnels that run under the town.
Some of the tunnels are old sewage pipes, but there are also lots of caves and old vaults down there. There are even some holes and crevices that rats don't dare crawl in. Some say there's a dark force.
That sounds ominous.
Never seen dark anything force. Myself, but I'm more worried about the zombies. They're spreading.
Zombies in seastone sewers?
Yes, there are. But Uncle Remy says sooner or later, an apprentice hero will go down into the sewage system and take on the zombies.
Huh. Remy told me you are often ill?
When I first heard of you, they said you were very sick.
I was often ill during the war. And hungry. Never had enough to eat until you came and helped us.
Oh, it was nothing.
Of course. Seemed like the thing to do.
Not for everyone. Some people treat us like vermin. Some people don't like it that Uncle Remy works for the Archmage and gets paid for it. But he doesn't even keep the gold for himself. He shares it between the whole family. And it's a big family.
Hmm. Remy looks tired.
I spoke to your uncle today. He looks tired.
He works too much. Ethel says that too. He doesn't eat enough and hardly sleeps anymore. He says, I can sleep when we've rebuilt the country.
He shouldn't overdo it. He'll be no help if he collapses.
That's why we have to help him. He wouldn't have to do everything on his own if you and me pitched in.
You and I? About the staff room.
About the staff room?
Yes.
I need to get in there.
But...
I need your help. Could you look through the notes on the headmaster's desk? He's a stickler for order, and I'm sure he'll have the door code written down somewhere.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
Why do you need to get into the staff room?
The headmaster was acting strange and was hiding something in a drawer. I want to know what he's up to.
Yeah.
Perhaps it's a bomb.
Maybe. We need to find out what exactly. But you're too small to open the drawer. That's why I need the code.
Got it.
Okay. You try and get into the staff room, then we'll meet back here, okay? Be careful.
I always am.
Hopefully that all goes well. Remy would never forgive me if something happened to Timmy, and I'd never, ever forgive myself.
Well, just watch out for the zombies.
The fire's melted the ice. Now it's water.
Oh.
A small glass with...
Fill it with water.
to the 2 cl mark exactly.
Then we just had to add that salt.
The glass holds exactly 2 cl of water.
Cool. Anything new going on in here?
Hey, Master Block?
Yes.
I need the code for the staffroom door.
I hear the door to the staffroom can only be opened with a code.
That is correct.
I never received the code.
That too is correct. I thought it would be a waste of energy giving you the code and then having to change it again once you are no longer a teacher at this school.
What?
But
I'm going to teach here forever.
The staffroom again tomorrow morning, as soon as I've opened the door.
But have to be going.
Goodbye.
He's unfair to me. I don't need to talk to Sloth at the moment. Hello, Blout.
Wilbur!
Can you just tell me what you wanted to say, Blout?
What did you want to tell me, Blout?
No, Sloth eavesdropping. I say nothing while Sloth listening.
Huh. I'm not going anywhere.
Bye, Blout.
Bye!
What did he do? Pick his own nose? Pick the other guy's head? Nose? Something? Oh no, just anything that could distract him. Shows off the protest posters.
I'm not happy that they're stopping our guests from reaching us. Many of their demands are much too far-reaching.
What do you think of the protesters' demands, Love?
But it's good that they question things. They will form a platform from which wiser and more level-headed people can contemplate how to really make the world a better place.
That dialogue didn't seem to go normally.
I'm sure you don't like the protesters, right, Blout?
Oh, loonies! Dangerous loonies!
What do you mean, dangerous?
Won't make everything different. Everything new. But everything better before. Blout not want things change and want everything be like before again.
Ah, right.
So I guess we show everyone these protest posters. Key! Soot! Let's show Headmaster Block the posters. No, I can't show it to him. We don't care about his opinion. Everybody pretty much know what it is, so. Oh, you're back. Any news?
You're back? What did you find out?
Lots of documents full of lists and numbers. Nothing suspicious. But I did find an entry titled door. With
okay.
Four numbers underneath. 4, 60, 9, 41. I wrote them down for you.
I just wrote them down.
You did great. These numbers are sure to be the code for the door. Thanks for your help.
Well, if you need my help again, you know where to find me.
Would you like to come with me? Maybe I can use a little partner somewhere.
Wow. Yes, please.
Cool. He's as an inventory item.
I can feel Timmy in my hat. Tickles a bit. Four, 60, 9, 41. These are the numbers that Timmy found in the headmaster's files. They should help me with the door to the staff room. The magic pisspot's legs may not be very thick, but they seem strong. I'm sure they could carry a golem body.
You had to go and stand just like that to say that? Here.
Hello?
What is the access code?
I know the code.
The code is 46941.
Correct.
I didn't have to write it down.
Then shouldn't you be opening right about now?
I don't know your voice. Headmaster Block hasn't introduced you to me.
Does he have to?
But I have the code.
I have a dual-level security system. The correct code must be delivered in the voice of a teacher whom I know.
That would have been too easy.
I'm Headmaster Block.
It's me, Headmaster Block.
I may not have the power of sight, but I do have an exceptional pair of ears. You are not Headmaster Block.
The door won't be fooled so easily. The code has to be spoken in Headmaster Block's voice. That is a bit of a problem.
Yeah, really?
Hello?
What is the access code?
Why is a staff room protected by such a sophisticated security system?
A code and a voice recognition system? Why so much security for a staff room?
We are in a school for magic. The pupils have ingenuity and astounding abilities at their disposal. If a pupil were to brew a potion and change themselves into a teacher, they still wouldn't have the code.
Oh, a potion, huh?
If someone happens to have the code but isn't a teacher, they still cannot enter.
All we need is a polyjuice potion.
I am a teacher.
If you were a teacher at this school, Headmaster Block would have introduced you to me.
Not necessarily.
I guess he didn't think it was necessary.
Uh-huh. Well, I've got to go.
I have to go. I have something to do down in the town.
I don't care. I'm just a door.
Maybe Timmy can be our two extra... Maybe Timmy can be our one cop counterweight or something. Maybe we could put him on the other side or something.
All that's left of the crocodile tears is a bit of salt. All right. Now, 2 cl of water to the salt, and I have the right amount of crocodile tears.
Right.
The concentration may be wrong, but I've never heard of that playing a role in alchemy. It's the amount that counts, the amount's the thing. Two CL of crocodile tears. Looks good. Crocodile tears are already in the pot. All that's missing are the soot and dragon sweat, and those are likely to be the most difficult to get.
Well, we already have the soot. No? Can't put a little Timmy used as a counterweight? Unless I have to find a torso from somewhere. And I have to make a polyjuice potion somehow.
Hello, Bill.
Bill, you have a polyjuice potion?
Wilbur.
I have to be going, Bill. See you next time.
See ya.
Stuttering. Hey.
Hello? X?
Shh. What do you want?
Are we supposed to give him the hammer and chisel?
Here's your chisel back.
Have you found the matching hammer?
Found and tested.
Lovely. Then I'll be out of here tonight.
Maybe he can help us.
Well then, I have to be going.
Take care of yourself, brother.
I should chat with X as little as possible. They could be watching us. Almost every house in the upper town has a drain leading to the sewer. In the lower town, things look different. Many residents just tip their...
Can we use him on this? Have Timmy climb down the sewage system?
Hey, Timmy, do you think you could find a way into the bakery through the sewers?
Oh, good idea.
Of course I can.
And maybe you could borrow a chocolate?
No, but I could steal one.
It's 2 sea stones.
I don't know. I don't want to incite you into doing something illegal.
It's not against the law for rats to steal food. It's expected of us.
Really?
Have you ever heard of a rat being thrown into jail for food theft?
Not really.
Oh, true. Off you go then. Hopefully it'll work. There's Timmy. He's inside. Looks like he can only carry 1 chocolate at a time.
What's the difference, red or blue? Red.
A red one. He understood me. He has the red wrapped chocolate and is heading up. What's he up to now?
Wilbur?
Ah, there you are.
The chocolate. Catch.
So he didn't go into the sewage system. He went up the drainage pipe.
Now it's your turn.
No need. Well, how did I do?
Good job, Timmy.
Timmy.
Red wrapped chocolate from the bakery. I'd like to eat it myself, but I don't think that would help things.
These are our counterweights.
A red wrapped chocolate. I'd like to eat it. I wonder if Zloff would help me with a golem if I got him some chocolates. There are the chocolates Zloff was talking about in the shop window. 2 sea stone small ounces of indulgence per chocolate. With and without alcohol.
Yep. So which is the one with alcohol? Which is the one without? One more.
I think we could use another chocolate. A blue one this time.
Okay.
There he goes, up onto the roof.
catch?
Thanks, Timmy.
Good work. A blue wrapped chocolate from the bakery. I'd like to eat it myself, but I don't think that would help things.
I know we have the map, whatever. It's pretty quick. And we're running late, but kind of want to get somewhere in this episode.
No, that wouldn't help. No, that wouldn't help.
Okay. Can we measure the soot now?
Right then. The counterweight weighs exactly 3 sea stone small ounces. The chocolate weighs 2 sea stone small ounces.
Right.
That means that when the weight is exactly the same on both sides, I'll have added exactly 1 sea stone small ounce to the pan. And that would be the case right now. Exactly 1 sea stone small ounce of soot, and in you go. Crocodile tears and soot are in the pot. All that's missing is the dragon sweat.
Okay. So all we need is dragon sweat. And we're gonna head back, give the chocolate to Sloft. And see how he can help us. Maybe he can help us find the dragon sweat or something else. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.